It's your host, Lori Lovell Barr of In My City. And tonight, we're at Cleopatra's Hookah Lounge for Essence of the Soul.
No, I don't see it often. And I probably should have told you I heard this back.
With one of our featured artists, Daniel Anthony.
Hey, what's good?
Daniel.
What's good? How you doing?
Good.
I'm doing great. I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. It's so great to be with you here tonight because I've been actually following you a little bit, and so this is going to be a great interview
awesome.
For me.
Awesome. Thank you. Appreciate the follow.
So let the people know a little bit about yourself. Where are you from? What's the genre of music that you're doing? And what are you doing here tonight?
Okay. Well, I'm originally raised in San Diego, California. Pretty much, I would say my whole childhood life, you know. I grew up on everything from Earth, Wind, and Fire to Al Jarreau to Chick Corea, you know, to just a whole bunch of like different styles of music, soulful music, you know, Tower Power horns and all that, you know what I mean? Everything that I listened to was based on just real music, you know what I'm saying? But my genre of music is gospel first, R&B soul after that. Once I got saved in 2004,
wow.
Yeah, it was just something that I knew I had to do, you know what I mean? I was actually kind of glad that I didn't really get to go full force with the music that I was putting out before. Mm-hmm. I was trying to be a bad boy, so, you know. But, you know, I had to get rid of that because, you know, I felt like God was really calling me to do something else, you know what I mean? So now I'm doing a different type of ministry.
Excellent, yeah. Excellent. I love that. So give us a little taste without telling us what you're actually doing tonight. What are you going to be doing and what are you looking for the people to get out of it tonight?
I would say the one thing would be for the actual message itself, you know what I mean? Like, I love R&B music, I love soul music. I love music, you know,
yeah.
But, you know, a lot of times, like, especially nowadays, you know, they've gotten, like, a little overboard, you know. It's like back in the day when Marvin Gaye was doing it, you know, like,
yes.
They used to say some things, you know, but they were not as, like, they didn't need a parental advisory sticker,
yes.
Right, you know what I'm saying? So I'm all about celebrating our love, you know, my wife's and I love, you know, and we've been together for, 17 years,
wow.
Married for 14,
oh
and
gosh.
It just, yeah, it's something that I want to celebrate, and it's something that I feel like since it's God, not only God-led, but also God-gifted, it's something that I want them to get and say, you know what, we can do away with some of the perverted stuff, you know, which is, you know, it's all right to have some things for the bedroom
I
and all
like that,
but
yeah.
At the same time,
save
you know,
a little mystery.
Right, there's no mystery no more, you know what I'm saying, so
it
I want to just take the time to celebrate, you know, and
that.
this project I have coming up, it's actually called 212, but I'm going to be releasing music, I would say, within a few months' time. So there's going to be one after another, so that way it could, like, hold on to the story, hopefully get people wanting more, you know what I'm saying? Currently, we're doing this thing called Carversations, where we talk about everything that happened from the day we met all up until the day we got married, so, yeah.
I love that. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so with that, are there any collaborations on this album or future albums, anybody you would like to work with?
Future albums, hopefully, not on this one.
Okay.
This one is actually I guess you could say a testament of progress because I just barely this past year started producing myself.
Wow, that's
you know,
excellent.
Yeah, it's really awesome. I mean, everything, you know, musicians know, like if you can't get something out of your head
mm-hmm.
onto something, you're gonna go nuts. You know, sometimes I end up like being awake late at night with all these melodies in my head and I try to do it, but I'm not a musician at heart, you know, unfortunately, but you know, I don't know how to play, but I know how to, you know, dabble a little bit, you know, so It helps that I can now finally get these things out, you know what I mean? And it's all because, you know, I've been gifted with certain things, like tangible things, you know, keyboard, you know, computer, things that I can use where I can finally get these things out. So I finally got the encouragement from my wife and a few other people to, like, branch out and really do things for myself, you know?
Excellent, excellent. I love that. Yeah. And before you go, we want to actually tell the people where they can follow you, find your music, and definitely buy that album.
Oh, most definitely, most definitely, yes. Well, I'm on Instagram at @I'm_DAnthony. Uh-huh. And then it's pretty much the same across the board on SoundCloud. Well, not SoundCloud, I'm sorry. What is it? Facebook is @I'm_DAnthony, no underscore.
Okay.
What else? Twitter is @I'm_DAnthony. So as long as you look for that, you'll be all right.
Excellent.
YouTube is Daniel Anthony Music.
Okay.
That's where all my videos and stuff are at.
Excellent.
Spotify is, I don't think they actually gave an actual tag, but you know
we're
what I'm
working
saying.
On that one.
Yeah, we're working on that. but yeah, so Daniel Anthony, you know, like I said, new music is coming out real soon.
Excellent, yeah. Excellent. Well, Daniel, thank you so much for doing this interview with us, and we look forward for more great things from you. This is Lori Lovelbar of In My City, guys. Stay tuned. Awesome.
Ever since the day, I surrendered to you, Lord, I've been trying to change my life for the better,
just for you.
But I know that it's gotta be for me too, so.